गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश टू क्लास एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 15 लीज. ओके नाउ कॉम्प्रिहेंशन. ओके आंसर विथ रेफरेंस टू द कॉन्टेक्स्ट. नो टाइम टू टर्न एट ब्यूटीज ग्लांस एंड वॉच हर फीट हाउ दे कैन डांस. सो वॉट डज ब्यूटी रेफर टू? ब्यूटी रेफर्स टू हर और यू कैन राइट नेचर और नेचर. ब्यूटी रेफर्स टू हर. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई डज द पोएट राइट ब्यूटी विथ अ कैपिटल लेटर? द आंसर इज द पोएट राइट्स ब्यूटी विथ अ कैपिटल लेटर टू शो द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ द नेचर्स ब्यूटी. टू शो द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ द नेचर्स ब्यूटी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज How does beauty spread herself around? The answer is beauty spreads herself around by dancing and smiling. Next, no time to see when woods we pass where squirrels hide their nuts in grass. So you have to circle the word which can replace woods in the above lines. The answer is forest. Number B. What does the poet convey through these lines? Take the appropriate answer. What does the poet convey through these lines? No time to see when woods we pass where squirrels hide their nuts in grass. The answer is enjoy the beauty of nature. Okay. Next question. Complete the following mind map is your homework. You have to write the poet's imaginary adventure. See where the squirrels hide the nuts in the grass. You can write streams full of stars. And you can write that watching beauty, dancing at her feet. Okay. So these you will find on your own and you will write on your own. Now let us move on to C, section C, question answers. Number one is, how is our life or what is our life full of? The answer is, our life is full of worries and anxiety. Okay. Next question is, what are some of the simple delights we miss in our rushed lives? The answer is, some of the simple delights we miss in our rushed lives are standing beneath the boughs and stare long like wandering sheep or cows while passing through woods, spotting where squirrels hide their nuts in grass, watching streams sparkling in broad daylight and admiring nature's beauty in its various forms. Okay, now let us move on to question number 4. Question number 4 is, which two words are repeated throughout the poem? The answer is, question number 3 also we have not discussed. Question number 3 is, what is there in the woods to see? In the woods, we see squirrels running off with their nuts. They are in a hurry to hide them from little thieves. Sometimes we can see endless number of sparkles of the sunlight reflecting upon the ripples of the stream. These sparkling beams of light appear like stars in the nightly sky. So, next question is number 4. Which two words are repeated throughout the poem? The answer is the words no time are repeated 7 times in the poem to highlight that we humans are so busy in our daily work that we have no time to admire nature and its beauty. Okay. Now number 5. What does the poet ask us to enjoy our lives? How does the poet ask us to enjoy our lives? The poet asks us to enjoy our lives by appreciating the beauty of nature and not running behind material things. We should adore and enjoy the beautiful activities of nature spread around us to make life meaningful. Okay, so this is the answer. Next is think and answer. Why is it important to have leisure in our lives? This you will write on your own, that why it is important to have free time in our lives. And second question is, what does the poet mean by the word stand and stare? The answer is to watch the beauty of nature. Okay, E number, make sentences with the following phrases given below. Full of care, beneath the boughs, and broad daylight. You will write this in your copy, you will make sentences. Next, F number, complete the table below with the words or phrases from the poem to match the meanings provided. One has been done for you. So, below meaning is given, the word taken from the poem is beneath. Okay, forest will be woods. A small animal with a bushy tail which feeds on nuts and seeds, it is squirrel. Next is to look briefly, stare, to improve the quality of something, enrich, bright day, broad daylight, or simply you can write daylight. Okay, so children, next is personification. What is personification? Means giving non-living things human form or living. Okay, through which inanimate objects are given human traits. It's called personification. Okay. Now, as it is given, the use of personification in the poem increases its beauty and appeal and importance. In this poem, nature has been personified as a beautiful lady and is referred to as beauty. Okay, so you have to underline the word that is personified in each sentence. The wind whispered through the dark, gloomy woods. So, the wind will be, wind is personified here. Because wind really cannot whisper. Okay, so wind is given human form here. Next is number two. Time crawled as he sat in the dark, dingy prison cell. Time crawled. Time is not human. So, time is here, you will underline. Time is personified. Freedom rang across the country on 15th August 1947. So, freedom is personified. The feathers danced in the wind. The feather is personified. Anxiety knocked at the door and he sat thinking about his result. Anxiety is personified. So, up to here we will do. Okay. So, this is the end of our class. In the next class, I will discuss the next chapter. Okay, till then, take care. Bye and thank you, children.